check you.
It has been 2 weeks since our newborn has joined our family, and there is a lot of things that I need to catch up on around the house. The first being bread. It's been a while since I baked bread. And so here I am going to be doing just a simple sandwich bread recipe in my bread maker, making enough to last the week. I've been blessed to have a very easy postpartum recovery. During delivery, I didn't tear at all, so I'm able to get up and do daily chores again and get back into a rhythm with my girls and the newborn. My husband also has some time off, so that has been a blessing in itself. We've been having a lot of family bonding time, a lot of newborn cuddle time, and it has just been so great. Delivery. I've been trying to eat a lot of iron-rich foods and just good wholesome meals that will help me with my milk supply and my energy. So here I am making kale soup, which is a really, really easy recipe. I will link it down below for anybody that wants to make it along with me. Essentially, this recipe is a one-pot meal. You just simmer everything until it gets soft and you blend it up in a blender and you add the kale at the end and it just tastes delicious, packed with vitamins and nutrients that the mama that just had a baby needs. Now, there is no shame in how much laundry you have when you have a newborn. Sometimes you can do all the laundry and still not get to it until the day you get to it. So me and my family are going to be putting away the laundry together so that it is quick and we hang our clothes instead of folding them. It's just quicker for us. And I found that, especially with the girls, it's just easier for them to hang something rather than folding.
Stays along. Is that along?
Heavy duty.
So a friend of mine lent me her bedside bassinet, and we just fell in love with it. It was a halo bedside bassinet, so we decided to buy one for ourselves. It swivels, it plays music, it vibrates, and it has little night lights for when you need to change them or anything like that at nighttime. And it's just the perfect bedside bassinet, especially when you co-sleep with your newborn. It is, I feel like, an essential thing. I was gifted this bread slicer from my mom, and it works so well. We used to just cut our breads rogue style, and they were diagonal, and the girls would cut it just like crazy ways. So this really helps when you bake your own bread and you want those uniform slices. This is such a great purchase. One thing that has been majorly neglected has been my sourdough starter. Poor thing. She has hooch on top of her, so I need to feed her. And when your sourdough looks like this, don't fret. Just put more flour, put more water, stir it up. And don't worry if you have hooch that's on top. That's the gray, watery substance. You just stir it right in. And the sourdough starter, if it is a strong sourdough starter, it should rise like normal. Me and the girls are very excited for spring to come around. So anytime the sun is out, we try to do something in our backyard. This time we are putting up a bird feeder, and we have been having a lot of little friends come and eat out of our feeder. Very exciting. So the needle on my sewing machine needed to be changed out, so I decided to do that, and then thought of creating a Bible cover for my Bible. And I had a bunch of cute fabric that I could use, so I thought of creating a little pocket to hold my pens and highlighters. And this sewing project is very easy. You just measure out your Bible or your book, whatever you want to cover, and then sew all the corners. It's just really just rectangles and putting it all together. I like it because it customizes your books, and it also is very functional if you add the pocket to the front.
Thank you.
sometimes you just crave breakfast for dinner. And so today we are cooking our favorite rice and eggs with vegan sausage because we are not eating meat on Fridays for Lent. So the vegan sausages are just as good as regular sausages. Believer in teaching your children early to clean up after themselves. So you are seeing Miss P here cleaning up her dishes very nicely. Good job, Miss P. We have a runner in our kitchen that was very, very dirty that has been on my to-do list for a while. So me and Miss P are going to be cleaning it with just a little bit of Dawn dish soap and baking soda, both very safe for kids to touch, which is very nice so that she can help me clean this dirty, dirty rug. Thank God that the sun is out and it's going to help me dry off the rug since it is not machine washable, unfortunately. I have been craving something sweet and I decided to make some carrot cake. This carrot cake is a great vegan carrot cake. So it has no eggs, dairy-free, but it does turn out very light and moist, and the frosting for it will also be vegan. It's going to be a spin-off of a cream cheese frosting, but there won't be any cream cheese in it. It's just going to have the taste. But if anyone wants to try this cake, let me know and I can post the recipe. Here's a little trick if you want to line your rounded cake molds. You get a piece of parchment paper, fold it in four, and trace around the pan. Cut it and it should fit perfectly, if not just a little bit over the mold. But once it comes out, it'll come out nice and neat and it will not stick to your pan. you for watching till the end. If you haven't already and you like this content, please subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.